हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? वेलकम टू मेहदी इंग्लिश स्कूल। माय सेल्फ नीलोफर मिस एंड माय सब्जेक्ट इज मैथमेटिक्स। सो आर यू ऑल रेडी टू अटेंड दिस ऑनलाइन सेशन? एंड डू यू नो व्हाट स्टूडेंट्स, दिस ऑनलाइन लेक्चर इज फॉर द क्लास टू स्टूडेंट्स। So I hope that you like this online lectures and you can understood through the videos, you are writing through the videos, you are completing your fair book also, you have to learn and write the things, you are getting the syllabus of the SA1. So please start a revision of the SA1 exam of all subjects. I am not telling you to do revision of only the mathematics subject. I am telling you to do the revision of all the subjects. You are getting the syllabus of all the subjects. So please start the revision of the SA1 exam. Now let's start the begin. Let's begin the lecture. So I am just repeating this quote. I am showing you the same quote today because this is very important quote for you. If you are just understood this quote, it will be a very easy for you. Now you can see this, that never give up because great things take time. I explained this quote in the previous lecture also, that never give up. What is the meaning of the give up? That give up means just leave it. Whenever you are trying to do something and that things is not properly doing, that things did not happen, so you leave the things, that this is not doing, this is not happen, so I leave it. So don't leave it, not give up, don't leave the things. So great things take time. So it will be take time, but the things definitely happen. So don't be give up of anything, whatever it is. It is a sum, it is a question of answer, it is anything. So great things take times. This is the very important quote for you students. Now you remember the name of this chapter, which is chapter number 8, exploring multiplication further. What is the name of this chapter? That exploring multiplication further. So today we are going to learn about the multiplication word problems. As you know that we are revising the previous chapter, previous topic we had learned, we are revising again. You know what, why we are doing that much revision of the previous lecture? Because this is the online session, you are not in front of me and I am also not in front of you. So if you have any doubt regarding anything, any topic, you are not directly asking me that, ma'am, what is this, how it is done, that how this digit will come, nothing. So that's why I am revising the previous lecture and explain to you this much slowly, because if you have any doubt regarding any topic, anything, so you can watch the videos and it will be a solve. If in the lecture, today's lecture, you are not understanding properly the topic, so in the next lecture I repeat this topic again, because if you are not understanding this topic clearly, your base will be not clear. You are not able to write the answer by yourself. That's why I am doing this much revision. That's why I am just try to, I just try my best to give you the best explanation. So that's why I am doing this much revision of the previous lecture. So if having any doubt related to the previous lecture, it will be a solve. So let's start the previous lecture revision first. It was the problem solving. So let's start this topic first. As I told you about the problem solving, so the steps of the problem solving is, first step of the problem solving is that you have to learn, you have to read the question two times first. You have to understand first that what is asking to us, what things we have to give, what is the question and what we have to give. These two questions you have to ask to yourself, that what to ask, that how. You have to read this first and then you have to find out that what to write, what we have to give in the answer. So after reading the question, you are understand that what we have to write, what we have to give as an answer. After understanding, we have to find something. What we have to find? We have to find the numerical information. What we have to find? We have to find the numerical information. After finding the numerical information, you have to put into the sum format. How we are calculating the sum, how we are solve the sum, we have to put that numerical digit in the proper way. We have to adjust, we have to arrange in the sum format, and then we have to put with the proper sign. What the sign? Sign means the addition, the multiplication, the subtraction. We have to decide that which information is given, what we have to give back as an answer, and which operation we have to follow. Addition, multiplication, subtraction, which operation we have to follow, we have to decide after reading the question. We must have this idea after the keywords. I am showing you, you already had learned the keywords, so many keywords you had learned, that from the keyword you are understand the keyword indicates it is a subtraction, addition or multiplication. So let's start the problem solving of the multiplication, and the multiplication problem solving is the easiest problem solving than the addition and subtraction. I repeat my sentence this, that multiplication problem solving is the easiest problem solving than the addition and subtraction. Now let's start explaining. I'm explain again these examples to you students. If you have any doubt related this problem solving, these examples, so it will be a clear today. So let's start the examples first. So as I told you, we have to read the question first. If you are not understanding, read the question 4 times, 5 times. You have to understand the question first. Try to find some numerical information. Find the thing what we have to give back as an answer. What the things we have to given already in the question first. So here is the question number one, example number one, that an insect has 6 legs. So first numerical information we found here, 6. An insect has 6 legs. We are found this information here, 6 legs. An insect has 6 legs. Here is the picture of the insect is. See, this insect has 6 legs. Let's count. This insect has 6 legs or not? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 6. You can count also. This insect has 6 legs. So I am putting 6 here. Now let's read again. Let's read forward. That how many legs 2, 3 insect have? This is the main thing. This is the question we have to give answer. This is the question want. This answer, this we have to give. How many legs do 3 insects have? So these types of, there are 3 more insects. So I am writing 3 here. You can understood this. Total 1 insect have 6 legs and these types of, there are 3 insects are there. So here is multiplication sign is already there. So we can speak the table number 3 or 6, both. Both are same. Now, I hope that you all know the table 1 to 10 very properly. सिक्स थ्रीजा और थ्री सिक्सा बोथ आर इक्वल टू 18. व्हाट? बोथ आर इक्वल टू 18. सो फ्रॉम द 18 वी कैन पुट 8 अंडर द वंस कॉलम एंड द वन विल मूव एज अ कैरी फॉरवर्डेड नंबर एट द टेंस कॉलम. यू कैन सी आई एम राइटिंग नंबर 8 अंडर द वंस कॉलम एंड दिस नंबर 1 इट कैन मूव एट द कैरी फॉरवर्डेड नंबर एट द टेंस कॉलम. दिस इज द टोटली एम्प्टी कॉलम. देर इज नो एनी डिजिट्स अवेलेबल एट द टेंस बॉक्सेस. सो वी कैन राइट डाउन दिस कैरी फॉरवर्डेड नंबर डिरेक्टली अंडर द टेंस कॉलम. सो द आंसर इज 18. एंड वी कैन राइट डाउन दैट आंसर इन द सेंटेंस फॉर्म. वेन एवर यू आर सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लम सेम जस्ट कीप दिस इन योर माइंड. You must give the answer in the numerical form, in the sum format also, in the and in the sentence form also. Both the way you have to give the answer. You have to write down the answer in the sum format also. And from this question, from this answer, from this sum, you have to give answer in the sentence form also. You have to give answer in the words also. So this way we can write down the answer in the words. That insect has 18 legs. How we can write that three insect has 18 legs. Now the next example for you. Some questions are different types that some information hide in this. So we have to just try to found that which information is hide in this question. So here is students, how many, let's read the question that how many legs do five table have? What is the question that how many legs do five table have? So you are thinking this question have only one numerical information which is five. I already write this five number, right? So this four I am writing here. This four from where come? This four number I am writing, but from where I am writing? Where I am finding this four number? So I am finding four from this picture. Read the question carefully that how many legs do five table have? So first we have to think that how many legs do one table have? This is the main question. This is the logical question. Here we have to ask that how many legs do five table have? So I am writing five. But here is the picture of table, the one picture. But we have to find that one table has four legs. You can count here the legs of the table. 1, 2, 3, and 4. This one table has four legs. So that's why I am writing 4 here. So now this table is complete. This sum is complete. That there are 5 tables and that type of that there are one table has 4 legs and that type of 5 tables are there. So total how many legs of 5 tables? So 5 fours are or 4 fives are. Both are equal to 20. How much? How many? Both are equal to 20. So we can put a 0 under the ones column and we can put 2 as a carry forwarded number at the tens column. Now you can see I am writing 0 here under the ones column. And this 2 number we have to put as a carry forwarded number at the tens column. What I am saying? From the 20, we can put 2 number as a carry forwarded number at the tens column. But these boxes are empty. These boxes are empty. So that's why I am putting 2 under the tens column directly. Without putting carry, we are writing 2 number directly. Why? Because this box's tens column is empty. That's why I am writing this 2 number under the tens column. Now after writing the answer in the numerical form, we have to write answer in the words also. So we can write down the answer in the words this way, that 5 table has 20 legs. We have to write 5 first. 5 table has 20 legs. This is the perfect answer, complete answer. Now the problem solving is complete. Now the sum number C, number 3. We have to read the question first. A tablet. Now you all know the meaning of the tablets, mobile phones, right? You all have, and you are watching this in the tablet or mobile phone or PC, right? You all have these things because you are study online. You are using this mobile phone, tablets and PC and laptop. What the things you have, right? So students, a tablet takes 3 hours to fully charge, and you also know the meaning of the fully charge. What is the meaning of the fully charge? It means whenever the charge is over, we have to charge it. And the tablet takes 3 hours to fully charge. So I am writing 3 here because here is the 3. It takes 3 hours to fully charge. Now let's read further. How many hours would it take to charge 4 tablets? That if one tablet is taking 3 hours, then after we are completing fully charged the one tablet, we are putting the second tablet on the charge. It takes 3 hours. Then we are putting the third tablet on the charge. It also takes the 3 hours to fully charge. Then we are putting the fourth tablet to fully charge, and it also takes the 3 hours. So that types of 4 tablets are there, and we are putting on the charge one by one. After one tablet is fully charged, then we are putting the second one. After second one is fully charged, we are putting the third one. After third one is the fully charged, we are putting the fourth one. In this sequence, we have to charge the tablet. So how many hours did it take? So that's why I am writing 4 here. Total there are 4 tablets, and one tablet take 3 hours to fully charge. Now 3 fourza is equal to 12, and also 4 threeza is equal to 12. So we can put 2 under the ones column and 1 under the tens column. Again I am explaining to you this, that here 2 I am writing under the ones column, and this 1 we have to put at the tens column as a carry forwarded number. But this tens column is empty. There are no any digit. This column is without any digit. So that's why I am writing 1 directly under the tens column. That's why I am writing 12 this way. Now we have to write down the answer in the words form also. We have to give answer in the words also. This way, that it takes 12 hours to charge 4 tablets. Here we are getting the 12 answer. So we can write down the answer in the words. We have to give answer in the words, that it takes 12 hours to charge 4 tablets. This way we can write down the answer in the words, in the sentence form also. Now the next example for you. There are 4 seasons in a year. So I am writing 4. There are 4 seasons are there in a year. So I am writing 4. The next one is, how many seasons in 4 years? There are 4 seasons in 1 year. So how many seasons in 4 years? So we are writing 4. There are 4 seasons and 4 years. So both are 4. So 4 fourza is equal to 16. So I am writing 16 this way. Why I am writing this way the 16? 6 under the ones column and 1 under the tens column. Here this way. We have to put this 1 as a carry forwarded number at the tens column, but I am not putting this as a carry. I am writing this 1 directly under the tens column here, because I am repeating again in every examples that these tens boxes are empty. There is no any digits in the tens column. The column is without any digits. That's why I am writing 1 directly under the tens column. Now this question is complete. I am writing the sum. But we have to give answer in the words also this way. That there are 16 seasons in 4 years. How we can write? How many seasons in 4 years? So we can write there are 16 seasons in 4 years. So this is the easiest way to write down the problem solving sum. The next example for you, that I buy 3 packs of 10 pens. How many pens I have bought? So I am writing 3. You are finding this 3 here. So I am writing 3. But from where I am writing this 10? From where I am writing this 10? So this 10 is hidden in this question only. You have to find the 10 from this question. Let's read this question again. If we are getting any information, so we can write down the 10. I have buy 3 packs of 10 pens. Here is the hidden information in the words. The numerical information is given in the words. This is the hidden information. You have to found, this is the logical question. You have to try to found. This is the general knowledge. If you are just finding the numbers only, but here the number are hidden in the words form. T-E-N, 10. 10, it means 1-0-10. You can see this T-E-N, 10, it means 1-0-10. Now, this is the sum is filled with the numbers. There are I buy 3 packs of 10 pens. So, I am writing 10 here. So, how many pens I have bought? We have to find that how many pens I have bought. So we can write down answer in the both way. 3 tens is equal to 30 and 10 threes is also equal to 30. So we can write down the answer this way. 3 0 30. And as you know that we have to give answer in the words also, not only in the numbers. In the problem solving, we have to give answers in the word form also. And here is the answer in the words form, that I have bought 30 pen, 3 0 30 pen. There are 3 packets and each packet have 10 pens. So how many pens I have bought? So we can write down the answer that I have bought 3 0 30 pens. I hope you understood this types of questions. This word problems is very easy compared than the other word problems. Now the next example for you. Here is a Newton can run 3 meters in a minute. I repeat this again, that Newton is a name, like your name is Abbas, Fatima, right? So many names are there. So this is the name like your name. Newton. My name is Niloufar. So this way the name is Newton, the name of the boy. Newton can run 3 meters. So I am writing 3 years. How much he runs? 3 meters in a minute. In a minute, it means in a 1 minute. He can run 3 meters in 1 minute. So I am writing 3 here. How far could be he run in 5 minutes? He can run 3 meters in 1 minute. So how he can run in 5 minutes? How many meters he can run in 5 minutes? So we can put 5 here this way. So we have to speak the table number 5 or 3. Both are same. 5 threes is equal to 15, or 3 fives is also equal to 15. Now we can put 15 this way, that 5 under the ones column and the 1 will move as a carry forwarded number. But we are not putting this as a carry forwarded number at the tens column. I repeat this again, that from the 15 I have to put this 1 as a carry forwarded number at the tens column. But this tens column is empty, there is no any digits, this column is without any numbers are there, this is totally empty. So that's why I am putting this 1 directly under the tens column. So the answer we are getting, the product we are getting is 1515. He can run 15 meters in 5 minutes. So we also have to give answer in the words. As I told you before also, that in the problem solve, always we have to give answer in the numerical form, this way in the sum form, and also in the word form. So here is the answer in the words form. That answer, he can run 15 meters. How he can run? He can run 15 meters in 5 minutes. This way you can write down this short words answer. You can give answer in the short words. In the few words also you can write down the answer. This is very easy. Now the next one. Eggs come in box of 6. Eggs come in the boxes of 6. So I am writing 6. What is the meaning of this? There are 6 eggs in one box. The meaning of this sentence is eggs come in boxes of 6. So there are 6 eggs in one box. What it means? What is the mean of this sentence? That there are 6 egg in one box. Then the next sentence we can read, how many eggs in 4 boxes? So there are 6 eggs in one box. So how many eggs in 4 boxes? This is the question. So this information we are finding, that total there are 6 eggs in one box. I'm repeating again and again, so you will be better understood this, that eggs come in boxes of 6. It means there are 6 eggs in one box. So I am writing 6. And how many eggs in 4 boxes? So I am writing 4. There are 1 box and 6 eggs. So there are 4 boxes. So how many eggs? So 4 6 or 6 4s, both are equal to 24. So we can put 4 under the ones column. And as you know that we have to put this 2 number as a carry forwarded number at the tens column here. But you know this, this boxes of the tens column is totally empty. There is no any digits are there in the tens column. So I am not putting this 2 as a carry forwarded number. I am putting this 2 directly under the tens column. Now how many eggs in the 4 boxes? There are 6 eggs in one box. So how many eggs in 4 boxes? So there are 24 eggs in 4 boxes. That much easy it is. So we can give answer in the sentence form also, that what we can write. So we can write down the answer in the words, that there are, here are 24 eggs in 4 boxes. What we can write down in the words? That there are, here are 24 eggs in 4 boxes. So students, in the next lecture we are going to do the textbook exercise. So be ready to do textbook exercise in the next lecture. So wait for the next lecture. We will do the textbook exercise in the next lecture. So students, we will do this textbook exercise in the next lecture. So till, you have to write down this all the examples into the fair book. So stay home, stay safe, wait for the next lecture. Bye bye students.